tout simplement vous, c'était d'adresser quelques mots à vos spectateurs, tout le public portugais qui vous attendait depuis longtemps.
Le seul mot que je peux dire est que j'espère qu'il sera content de moi. Je suis ici pour lui faire content et voyons, nous sommes dans la main de Dieu et ça c'est tout.
Merci bien, c'est très gentil.
Je n'ai pas encore vu rien de Lisbonne, je ne peux pas dire naturellement les choses communes, que ça me plaît, ça ne me plaît pas.
J'espère bien
seulement
que Lisbonne
qu'il
vous plaira. J'en suis sûr.
Ça, c'est tout.
J'en suis sûr que Lisbonne vous plaira.
Je salue avec grande chaleur les portugaises.
Comme sans doute, je suis sûr que vous plairez au public portugais qui vous attendait, comme je vous avais dit, depuis longtemps. Et nous sommes très heureux et très flattés de vous avoir en ce moment parmi nous.
J'espère de me faire, mon devoir, de tout ce que je peux.
Merci bien.
Chanter bien.
Vous aimez sans doute l'opéra que vous allez chanter, la Traviata.
Bien sûr. Je viens pour le chanter, c'est logique.
C'est vous qui l'avez choisi, madame,
pour chanter ici au Portugal? Moi, je ne choisis rien. On me dit ce qu'on veut. Et si je le veux, je l'accepte. Sinon,
vous savez, madame, pardon. Vous savez que...
Mais ça, c'est...
Ah, c'est assez déjà. Merci bien, c'est très gentil à vous. Soyez la bienvenue au Portugal. Merci.
Je vous remercie infiniment.
Merci bien, madame.
Alle spalle della Callas ha trionfato Meneghini perché finalmente aveva in mano l'asso, diciamo così, il jolly con il quale lui si imponeva, perché lui, cioè un marito, amministrava la Callas, era lui il manager, non c'avevano nessun altro, perché dal 1947 fino al 59, cioè fino a che lui è rimasto assieme alla Callas, lui teneva nota di tutto quello che la Callas percepiva. Tristano Isotta, 85.000 lire a recita. A luglio, 90.000 lire a recita. A ottobre, già 100.000 lire. Cioè, lui vendeva la Callas come se fossero laterizi, cioè, capisce, un prodotto, e cresceva sempre, sempre di più, sempre di più, sempre di più. E qui, da questo punto di vista, si può dire che è stato anche utile, perché probabilmente Maria non sarebbe mai riuscita a spillare così tanti soldi dai vari teatri, e risulta che sia stata la cantante più pagata in assoluto nella storia della lirica.
Les trois saisons qu'elle a faites à New York, au Metropolitan Opera, j'ai été présent. J'ai eu la chance d'assister à beaucoup de ses spectacles.
Et pas de scandale?
Non, pas de scandale. Non, une grande excitation au moment de ses débuts à New York, une excitation enfin collective dont on ne peut pas avoir idée en France ou même en Europe, car il n'y avait pas une boutique, fût-ce une teinturerie ou un drugstore, dans laquelle il n'y avait en devanture une statue de Maria Callas ou des effigies d'elle. Enfin, c'était un événement extraordinaire, comme la visite d'un chef d'État étranger.
I'm famed. I have been given lots of names, tigress, temperamental, goodness knows what. Nobody has ever accused me of not being disciplined. I don't like to be told what to do because I know my job very well.
Madame Callas, in the last few years, particularly since you've been associated with the Met, you've received a tremendous amount of adverse publicity. How do you account for that?
I have been brought to exasperating situations.
She had this love-hate relationship, as you know, with Rudolf Bing, who who was trying to his best to get her to come to the Metropolitan Opera, and he offered her many roles, even the Queen of the Night, originally, I think, he offered her. And it was extremely difficult because of these financial negotiations, which went on and on and on and on. Well, finally, of course, she sang there. Meneghini interposed himself. He said, for instance, Madame Callas will not appear at the Metropolitan Opera anymore because the fee wasn't right or something. How could he say that? He probably hadn't asked her. You know, he went too far almost.
Last Friday, at the opening of the Dallas City Opera season, Rudolph Bing sent Maria Callas a best wishes telegram, but asking why Dallas. On Wednesday, he sent another telegram, which became an ultimatum. Callas held her fire until a press conference after Thursday's performance of Medea. Then she blew the lid and tells Mr. Bing why Dallas.
Why in Dallas and not here? That's something I'd like to tell him. Why doesn't he do these performances at the Met? And I would be there with pleasure. But in any case, very best wishes for triumphant success.
Who is that from?
Bing.
Just one more line.
Please let me hear from you. Regards.
And when was that received?
Well, here you are. I'll serve the forget.
Emailed it October 31st.
By Rudolph
Bing. That's a very ironic wire.
It is.
Why in Dallas and not here? That is what we're asking him. A commanding way. Either you answer me tomorrow or breach of agreement and contract terminated. I think what got into the man? Excuse me, lousy performances. And I cannot change artists every performance. Now you can know it. Each performance we have, if we do 10 Macbeths, 10 different tenors, 10 baritones. No, I'm sorry. I can't do that. That's not art. Well, Leo, I mean, let's get it out now while we're at it. Do you know that last year I did Traviata, never seen the set?
You know, there was one famous occasion. You remember Bing, who was a very, very old man, and I knew him quite well. Also a very hard man. He said some interesting things, but at one Lucia performance, the baritone had held a note too high, too long, and Maria cried out, "Basta!" And of course, basta means stop, you know, and the Metropolitan Orchestra and the audience, they don't speak Italian, they thought it was something else, you know, so the basta was made headlines the next morning, and they were all quite shocked.